Welcome to Elite Golf Coach's Tip. This is my tip this month. We're going to talk about the initial move away from the takeaway and how important that initial move is for setting up what's going to come on after in the golf swing. Most of the mistakes are generally either made at setup or in the initial move. And then what happens is that you have to then rely on manipulation to try to correct it. And when you rely on manipulation, you're relying on timing. And if your timing goes, that's where the problem starts. So, once we've got the general setup, right? The basics, the setup, the grip, the posture. What we're then looking at is how we move that first movement back in the golf ball. So, what we're going to look at from here, I'm going to put down two tall sticks here. And these are basically going to be pointing. If you imagine we were straight ahead, they would be pointing towards my target in the distance. Okay, so if those pin poles were 150 yards long, they would hit my target. Now I'm going to take out my 7-iron, and what I'm trying to do here, I'm putting my golf ball in the middle of the sticks. So I've got about sort of 15, 18 inches either side. And what I'm trying to focus on is trying to keep the first movement working back in a straight line. Okay, so as I take the club back into the takeaway here, the club is going to work back in a straight line. So at the moment, what I tend to see when people, when they make the first movement, they tend to either lift the club away and go out towards the stick on the right here, or they whip the club way far too behind them on the initial move. So what I'm going to try to feel today is when I take the club back, that first movement, the club is going to work back in a straight line, and it's going to exit out the top of those sticks, right between the two. So I'm not moving out towards the outer line, I'm not moving in towards the inner line. I'm working on keeping the club head moving back in a straight line, and that will help me get into my neutral position at waist height of the club running on my toe line. Okay, so as I do that movement, for that to work correctly, I'm feeling my shoulders doing the work, my arms, my shoulders, and the club, this wire created here, moving back as one. So as I take the club back, I'm not using my hands, I'm not lifting my arms, I'm using my shoulders and body and moving the club back here. So just to show you this, I'm going to do a little preset first where I show my body before I hit it what I'm looking for. Just once or twice showing it coming out the end of the sticks. Then I'm going to go into my shot. As I hit the shot there, I'm trying to feel also as I go through the shot, the club staying down through the sticks on the forward swing as well. So it's really key, that first sort of 12 to 15 inches of the swing, trying to create that straight takeaway and keeping the wrist passive so you can work the club on a straighter path. Basically, for you to understand, if the club goes too much on the inside, you tend it then to go in to out, which will then cause pushes or hooks, depending on where the club face is. Or what we can see is when the club goes inside, it causes the dreaded over the top. Vice versa, once you lift it away, it creates the out to in, which causes pulls and cuts again in relation to where the face is. But what we're trying to do today is really sort out that pass. So the first movement, put your sticks down when you practice. Literally about either side of my golf club, I'm going to have about an inch and a half gap between each stick. And I'm going to focus on keeping my club working in a straight line up those sticks. Now use that when you go to the practice area this week. You should see a big difference in the straightness of your ball flight. I hope that helps you. We'll see you for the next month's tip.